We'll begin this yoga nidra practice in Shavasana. Please lay back.
As you let the body further relax and settle into this shape, on your next inhale, draw your inhale all the way down to the base of your spine. Follow the exhale as it flows all the way up and back out through the mouth, through the nose. Inhale, drawing all the way down to the base of your spine, and then exhale, flowing all the way back up and out. And you may even start to visualize the breath as something tangible, maybe as a mist or a color of gas or smoke or whatever it might be that helps you follow with your mind's eye this path of the breath on each inhale and each exhale. And on your next exhale, release that breath fully and release any visualization around it, any image that's attached with the breath. Just let the breath go and return to a normal cycle of breath, inhaling and exhaling. And I want you to imagine in your left palm, a ball of light. And see it with your mind's eye. See a particular size, a particular brightness. It might even have a color to it, but with your mind's eye, visualize this ball of light in your upturned left palm. And on your next inhale, draw the ball of light all the way up the left arm, all the way up through the neck to the center of the forehead. And on your exhale, send the ball of light down the right side to the palm of the right hand. And on your inhale, draw the ball of light up the right side to the center of your forehead. And on the exhale, send it all the way down the left side to the left palm, completing one cycle. And then continue on drawing the ball of light on the inhale up the left side to the center of the forehead and down the right, and so on, at the pace that suits the pace of your breath. As this ball of light moves through the body, move your awareness with it. So it is your awareness that is traveling through the body. as you do this, you may notice that there are certain places where it is easy for that ball of light, that consciousness, to move through. And then there may be places where it is more difficult to move that ball of light, to move your consciousness through. It may even be as though there's a skip in a certain part of the body. And it's no problem, but notice that. Oftentimes there are parts of our body that we have disconnected from. For many different reasons, sometimes an injury, or maybe a history, or a feeling about a part of the body that causes us to block it off. Sometimes, even in the course of this practice, some of that space of density might open up a bit. You may start to draw your consciousness through more, but it's okay if it stays dense and blocked off a bit. Just continue to draw that ball of light, draw that consciousness from palm to forehead to palm and back. If you lose your way, if you get distracted or drawn into sleepiness or thinking, just start right back at the left palm. Remember that if you begin to drift off, you can lift an arm or prop up a knee to keep you this side of consciousness longer. And the next time you draw that ball of light to the left palm, don't rush it whenever it gets there. Just keep it there. Wherever you are in the cycle of breath, we'll meet up. With the ball of light in the left palm, and then release it. And draw the ball of light now to the sole of the left foot. And actually feel it there, see it there. And on your inhale, you'll draw the ball of light up through the left leg, the left side body, and all the way to the center of the forehead. And on the exhale, all the way down through the right side body to the sole of the right foot. On your inhale, back up to the center of the forehead. And on the exhale, all the way back down to the sole of the left foot, completing one full cycle, and you'll continue on from there. And there's much more distance to travel now in the span of a breath. But see if you can keep your consciousness linked to the movement of that ball of light. So as the ball of light moves through the body, so does your consciousness move through the body. And again, there may be places where you notice it is easy to draw your consciousness through. And there may be places where you notice it is dense and closed off. the next time you bring that ball of light to the sole of the left foot, let it stay there. And then release it. Now, as you deepen your breath, feel as though you're breathing with the whole body. Feel the perimeter of your skin between the inside you and outside. And feel the breath move out in all directions at the perimeter of the skin, as though the whole body were expanding and contracting with each breath. And see if as you breathe, you can expand out even more, breath by breath. Now see if you can start to breathe out beyond the perimeter of your skin. See if you can start to breathe out beyond the physical body, and with each breath feel out into the space around you. Extending your being, your awareness in all directions out beyond the perimeter of the skin, and see with each inhale how much more expansive you can get. Still with this expansion and maybe a light falling back on the exhale. slowly start to draw this back. So within the next few cycles of breath, you are once again breathing at the perimeter of your skin. So that once again, you're breathing with this full bodiedness, feeling the expansion on the inhale of the whole body and the contraction on the exhale of the whole body. Bring your hands to your heart and feel the rise and fall of your breath underneath your palms. Feel this as the source of all the expansion. Take a big breath in and exhale it out. With your eyes closed, roll onto your side. Eyes closed, come on up to seated. Hands together in front of your heart. Take a big breath in. Exhale it out. Bring your thumbs to your forehead as a thank you to yourself and to each other. As we bow, we say namaste.
Namaste.